When I was a child, they always would chase us out of shul for Yisker. You're familiar with the Yisker services we do on the holidays. And they never allowed people with parents to stay in the synagogue. You know that? It's a very interesting custom. Now, I loved it because it was a free permission to leave the synagogue. And once you were out, you never came back. So it was good. Once you were out, you were. So I didn't mind. But when I got older already, so I had an interesting experience once. I grew up in the Crown Heights section of Brooklyn. And Yom Kippur, the Lubavitcher Rebbe would say what's called Maftir Yonah, the Maftir about Jonah being swallowed in the fish. And it was a very emotional experience to hear him say it. And then at the end of Yom Kippur, he would jump up on a chair and dance some song that Napoleon's soldiers used to sing. It's called Napoleon's March. And he would get up on a chair at the end of Yom Kippur. It was a very powerful spiritual experience. And I had a good place, and I didn't want to lose it. But by Yisker, I had to go out because both of my parents are alive. And once you went out, there were 10,000 people rushing back in. You lost your place. So I decided I'm going to hide in the shul behind a beam so people won't see me. And that way I'll be there. And the shul was empty because anybody who had parents, which means a lot of young people, were gone. And then by the time the doors open and everybody crosses back in, I'll be the first because I'm already in the synagogue. The Lubavitcher Rebbe was on the bima, and they were starting Yisker. And I remember there was an eerie silence in the shul. It was mostly empty. People didn't have parents, but most of the people were young and they had parents, thank God. And the Rebbe looked around and his eyes hit the point where I was behind the beam. And he looked at me with such intensity in a very, how do I say it, clear and intense way, you really don't belong here. So I ran out of shul. I ran out of shul. It was fascinating because I was behind a beam. If he was standing, I was like behind a beam, and I was like hiding. I was like near. If those who know the structure there, it was near the entrance to what used to be the back bathrooms. And I was saying, he gave a look. I ran out.